Welcome to general readings for, oh my gosh, we're in June already. Your money readings are going to look like this, and your love readings are going to look like this. And so you can be looking forward to those to come out throughout the month. So let's get started. Okay, Virgo. So, okay, somebody hurt you, somebody broke your heart, you know, and you're afraid that it's going to happen again. Well, you know what? Fuck that person, okay? And let's just not deal with them anymore. Simple fix, because the next person isn't necessarily going to treat you the same way that so-and-so did from before, or so-and-so did from before, or so-and-so did from before. And whether this happens in your friendships, your family, romance, at work, doesn't matter how it plays out for you this month. That's kind of the vibe. And so they're saying that the music can help heal, that music can help you get through things, can help you heal through them and feel more confident about the future. A lot of times, you know, like we can just listen to like a sad ass song and like sing it and cry and feel really cathartic and then be easier move on from it, right? Or maybe you want to listen to music that is uplifting, that gets you pumped up and ready to get moving in the direction you want to. It seems like this card just keeps popping up for everybody. It's new opportunities are coming in the beginning of the month for you that you should take advantage of. They're really positive for your long-term future. The middle of the month, people are appreciating you. They're noticing you. They're thankful that you're around and that you do what you do. And by the time we get to the end of the month, you have a solid long-term future goal and plan. Like your future is secure and it's safe. So this might be that you find a job that you stay in until you retire, or perhaps this is a marriage, you meet the person you're going to marry. But basically it's like you've just started on this new path that leads to this like happy ever after kind of destiny that you've been trying to manifest in your life. So the best part of the month for you is that there's a lot of love going around, a lot of love to be received and a lot of love to give. The biggest challenge for you this month is to trust your intuition. So your intuition is gonna be on point, but do you trust it? Can you tell the difference between your fears and your thoughts? And so separating that is gonna be really important to try to do. The guidance for you this month is like understanding that after every rainstorm, you know, the sun does eventually comes out. And that sometimes disappointments that happen are just because something better is coming for us. And I really feel like good opportunities are coming here for you this month. And so make sure that you're paying attention and that you're not afraid to jump on board and take advantage of those. If you need assistance with any of these energies, your crystals of the month look like this. You can find those in my blog page on the link below. And I love you so much.